first lecture on complex number, which equals A omega, where omega, of course, is angular frequency, which is equal to 2 pi f, times exponential I, where I is the imaginary number, I times phi of omega. A omega is a modulus or magnitude. We are using the complex number. We are using the complex number properties very clearly here. Okay, so now we are seeing what we studied in the first lecture is we are using here. A omega equal the magnitude of F omega, which is the square of R omega added to the real part, square of the real part added to the square of the imaginary part under the square root. Phi omega, this one is called the amplitude spectrum. We are going to use the amplitude spectra very often in our seismic application. All seismic application, seismic reflection, seismic refraction for filtering, for example. Even for other applications, seismic application like surface wave, when there is type or technique for using surface wave to study the structure of the Earth, the shallow structures of the Earth. And this we are going also to use the Fourier spectrum and amplitude spectrum. The phi of omega equal the arctan, 10 minus 1, arctan of I omega, the imaginary part divided by the real part. So the phase is an angle, the angle between the phases or the constituent or the phases of the energy. So in seismic and body wave, you know, you studied types of seismic waves before. We have body waves and surface waves. Of course, you know it. For body waves, we seldom use phase spectrum. Generally speaking, we seldom use phase spectrum. Why? Because phase spectrum occurs only when I have what's the so-called dispersion phenomenon. The dispersion is that the velocity change with frequency. When the frequency change, the velocity change. So for frequency for surface waves, there is remarkable feature. There is dispersion, and so the shape of the wave change as the frequency change as we move from point to point over the Earth's surface. However, for body waves, this dispersion phenomena is so rare. It's not seen. So usually in our work, in our studies through our seismic reflection data, we are focusing on A omega. We are also, we will get some hints about the phase spectrum, but our focus will be directed to amplitude spectrum. When does the Fourier transform work? We have two main conditions. The first one is that the f of t function, which is the time series I have, should be finite, should have finite number of jumps. And the limits exist from both sides. This one is not good enough when applying Fourier transform, because there is jumps, more jumps. As you've seen in the Fourier representation, at these jumps, phenomena called overshooting occurs here. Due to the change from value to, from higher value to lower value, suddenly the Fourier transform fails, and some leaking of energies, artificial energies, are leaked into the spectrum, and then the data become noisy. So we will know at that time if I have something like that, I can use what's called tapering technique or tapering function. Okay. So I should have something like that. Here I'm speaking about the envelope. Something like that. The energy should be okay. So I should have finite number of jumps. We add the limits from both sides exist. Okay. The second one that the function itself should be integrable. If it's not integrable, I cannot apply integration. I cannot integrate, so the transform will not work. There is some properties of Fourier transform for some special functions. For example, when the original time series or function is even, its Fourier transform will be even. If the function was odd, its Fourier transform will be odd also. If the real of the function f of t is real, its Fourier transform will be Hermitian. If the function f of t is imaginary, the Fourier transform will be anti-Hermitian. When the function f of t is Hermitian, its Fourier transform is real. Hermitian. Okay. Hermitian is the function is a complex function, and it is for say f of x, which x is a complex number, equal minus f of x asterisk. This means the conjugate, a complex conjugate of x with the sign change. This is called Hermitian function. Yes, for complex number. Okay. We have some maybe we should apply tapering to reduce some of the jumps and noises. Now we have some important properties of Fourier transform. Fourier transforms are linear, which means that adding two time series, each of them multiplied by scalars A and B, equal the addition of their frequency transform, Fourier transform counterparts multiplied by also A and B, the two scale. So this is called linearity. The transform keeps the nature and it's linear, so that we can move from one domain to another freely. This is important when we are going to solve some problems in mathematical physics or in modeling and applying the so-called synthetic seismograms. For synthetic seismograms, we should start from the equation of motion, which is a partial differential equation. And so we are going to use Fourier transform to transform the equation to frequency domain, or in other words, to transform the equation to somehow time algebraic equation, and then applying our solution on the partial differential equation. After solving for the coefficient, we return back with the inverse transform to get the time domain solution. This is some easy representation. It's the situation is much more complex, but I'm trying to make it somehow easier so that we can imagine what's going on. I'm not sure you will have a course for modeling and something like that in your study or not, but this we usually apply transforms for, like applying Laplace transform, also applying Laplace transform, we change ordinary differential equation from being integral or differential equation to algebraic equation, solve for equation for coefficient, and then applying inverse Laplace transform, you took Laplace transform. Yes. And you sure you know the application of Laplace transform and other transform also. It's also symmetry. We have symmetry in the Fourier transform, meaning that if I change it, the order of time or times, of the time series by multiplying by negative one, also the spectrum is inverted by negative one, multiplied by 2 pi. 2 pi here is for scaling. Okay? Time shifting. Time shifting means that I shifted the time points I have a little bit by an amount equal delta t. This results in the Fourier transform will be exponential I omega delta t times the original spectrum. Time differentiation, which is very important, and we use many or frequently in Fourier transform and in solving problems regarding elastic wave field or seismic wave field. The summation of f of t according to time for n times equal minus I omega raised to the power n times the Fourier transform of f t. So if I have say displacement. You know, any motion, any movement is either displacement, okay, velocity, and acceleration. For example, I'm moving from this point to this point. Okay? Moving from this point to this point, if you measure the distance, it's called displacement. So if you divided this displacement by the time I take from this point to this point, you get the velocity. Okay? And then if you divided the velocity by the time, again, I talk, you get the acceleration. So what we actually have, or what we actually record, we have the, here is the geophone. Okay. What we actually record is the motion of this particle. The particle just under the geophone or seismometer. When the seismic energy comes to this point starts to vibrate. So if the geophone is measuring the displacement, this one will be displacement record. If it measures or sensitive to frequency, so this seismogram will be velocity gram or velocity seism, the velocity of vibration, not the velocity or the wave speed of the layers. If the for some application like in engineering one, when you want to when you want to do the force of seismic energy for explosion, for example, or for earthquake and its effect on building, for example, we use acceleration. So if this instrument is strong motion or recording acceleration, so this record will be an acceleration. Hence, I can, if I have displacement, I can use this identity to estimate velocity from displacement, to estimate acceleration from velocity, and vice versa. Okay? Is it clear? What differentiation do is that it increases the frequency. Here time domain, here in frequency domain. You see that, you know, the frequency is the time for one cycle. Okay? The frequency is the time taken for one cycle. This is the frequency. Okay? Its unit is hertz. So this is half cycle. Okay, and this one is also half cycle, but in frequency domain. What differentiation do is that it increases frequency. Here the frequency is increased by 2. Here, in this case. Okay? So differentiation generally increase the frequency. So displacement is lower, generally lower in frequency, but when differentiating to get velocity, I'm expecting to have higher frequency. When differentiating to frequency, I'm expecting to have higher or the highest frequency content in frequency record. For Fourier transform example, we are going to use the same example for Fourier series. The line f of x equal x, and also the boxcar. For the line function, which f of x equal x, where x belongs to minus pi to pi, which is zero outside this interval. F here, as we said, is odd, then f cosine kx is odd, and so the fc of omega, fc of omega here is used as abbreviation for cosine transform. We have the Fourier series, we have cosine and sine. So we can separate the Fourier transform into two parts, cosine transform and sine transform. So here, the cosine part equals zero, which is the same like what we when we spoke about the coefficient of Fourier series. And thus, the sine transform here is 2 over pi from 0 to infinity x sine omega x dx. The final form is, as here we have, 2 sine pi omega minus pi omega cosine pi omega divided by pi omega square. When this one is plotted, it gives this graph. This graph means that I have higher amplitude at lower frequency, and then the amplitude decays with at higher frequencies. Okay? Sometimes we are going to use this phenomena in our course when trying to find something like the region, the resolution, and so on. So we need to have idea about the frequency content of the record. Another example also is the box example. Here, f of omega equal from minus infinity to infinity, the function box of x, e exponential I minus I omega x dx. Again, the box equals zero outside below below minus one and after one. So the integration is limited here to from minus one to one. And the box, the value of the box function is one. So it is integration of the exponential function from minus one to one. The integration equal I exponential minus minus I omega x divided by omega in the interval from minus 1 to 1, which gives the value from I e to the power or exponential minus I omega divided by omega minus I exponential I omega divided by omega. Using the identity that exponential minus I omega equal cosine omega minus I sine omega, again, we have this identity in complex number. Then the spectrum here become equals to 2 sine omega divided by omega, which is the sinc function. So the Fourier transform of the box equal the sinc function, and also the Fourier transform of sinc function is the box. Okay. If we are going to, or we are looking for generalization of this relation, the box we can change from minus one to one to from k minus k to k. So we have another. We have some general form. The Fourier transform will be 2 times sine k omega divided by omega. And the graph will have this shape for the transform. You see, as the k increase, as the weights increase, as the weights of the time interval or the weights of the box function increase, its spectrum becomes narrow. When it decreases, the spectrum becomes wider. Okay. The important application of Fourier transform We have three main application that will be the topics of next week lecture. The first one is the convolution and deconvolution. The second one is the sampling of seismic time series. And the final one is the filtering of seismic time series. Thank you, and I hope today's lecture was interesting.